Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Growing up, most kids know that they, okay. Growing up, most people rely on every person that they can because that's what you're used to. You're used to relying on your parents, and you're used to relying on like older siblings, older classmates, captains, players, anything. And also when you're younger, you think that you are always right. I know I still think that a lot of the times, but I know, especially as an athlete, when I was little, I thought everything I was doing was right. It worked for me up until now. I'm doing it right. No coach has ever talked to me. And just standing here today, I know that at this point in my life, which will be my senior year and last season of volleyball at LHS, was a time when I was at my best. Leading up to the 2017 season, little old Maddie, well, junior Maddie and lower, not that young, cared about her sports, but in the wrong way, I guess, more about winning and losing than I didn't care how people saw me attitude-wise and action-wise. If I got mad, I let it show. If I got mad, I lashed out at people, and that was disgusting. And I also, as a player, I was not someone who took direction very well. Like I said, I thought I was right when it came to athletics, because I've been playing them for so long, I know what I'm doing, blah, 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 I know the sport. And I really took that to heart because, like, when someone yelled at me, I took that to heart because I'm like, okay, well, they're not telling me what to do, they're just telling me that it's wrong. Also, when I made a mistake, a lot of you, most of you in here have played a sport with me and are in a sport with me right now, and when I make a mistake and I do something wrong, normally it's, gosh dang it, Madison Ray, there might be some other words in there, but I yell at myself because I hate making mistakes, and in my head, I find every single way possible to not put the blame on myself. I blame, oh, my shoe wasn't tied, oh, she got in my way, or someone did this, someone did that. I did not want it to be my fault because I don't like making mistakes. I'm kind of a perfectionist. Another thing that I wasn't good at, the old version of Maddie, was organization. My organization skills were absolutely horrible. I wore two different socks to practice. Most of the time I wasn't wearing my shirt because I lost it. I pulled a Madison, which most of you know what that is I can't find something, and then I will find it literally 10 minutes later. Jasmine knows this from volleyball. She'll be like, calm down, don't freak out, you're spazzing out. And then I literally find it 5 minutes later in the place where I knew it was. And also the fourth aspect to younger Maddie in athletics is I was solely dependent on the girls that were older than me. Especially in volleyball and softball, I relied on like Ashley Warren and Kendra Beavers and Bryn Wall and Hallie Early. I relied on them to keep my attitude in check, to keep me organized, and to keep me going, and to just look at me and be like, knock it off, you're being a little brat. I needed that from them because I couldn't find the power to do it myself. But about a month into the season, Swenson told us to corner up, and he said, all right, it's time to pick captains. And this was for volleyball, Swenson's volleyball coach. And this was kind of nerve-wracking because it's something that I had always wanted to do. My sister was the captain, and I just thought, I'm not gonna let my sister beat me. Like, I kind of wanted it, and it'd just be a really good experience for me. And this was the beginning of my at my best transformation. So I kind of separated it into four chunks. I talked about taking direction, mistakes, organization, and being dependent, and that those were the old ways. And I'm gonna talk about how they kind of changed. So it's gonna be four chunks again. Knowing it was mine and Cassie's last season as captains to kind of take the volleyball team wherever us seniors wanted it, I knew that Coach Swenson wasn't going to take it easy on us, and I knew that if I made a mistake, he was going to be on my butt about it, because if he's not going to be on me about it, and if I'm not going to be on myself, and if I'm not going to challenge myself to be better and ask questions and be able to take that direction, then how could I expect the rest of my team, who were mainly freshmen, to do the same thing? I learned to lead by example. In the past, like I said, nothing was ever my fault in my brain, and that was completely wrong. I said it out loud multiple times, but it wasn't right. And I completely changed my thinking, and I started taking the blame for everything, even if it clearly wasn't my fault. And it was like, I changed my thinking to, oh, she did this, she did that, to now, what did I do, what could have I done? And I did that in my head. And captains can't be those people who are constantly blaming other people. You have to take action for yourself. And as one of the oldest ones on the team, I remember, like I said earlier, Bryn and Hallie teaching me how to be organized with my thoughts and with my like getting everyone on time, because before I was kind of late, I would like walk to the bus, I'd do this, oh, we have time. But when you're in charge of a team, you're forced to keep everyone else on track. Like we had to get jerseys, we had to make sure everyone had, our team was very big on food, make sure everyone had food, make sure everyone had shoes, jerseys. That was all of our responsibility. And also another big change was that it forces you to take control, and I kicked myself to be brave and take control of situations on and off the court. Like, we had a new drama, and that was part of being dependent on others. I didn't have anyone to be dependent on. It was just us four seniors. There's only four of us. And I couldn't be reliable on Coach Swenson because he doesn't necessarily know what goes on and off the court. That was our job as captains, to stop drama. We also had to learn how to, we had to figure out each individual player and how they worked. And to wrap up my speech during my final season, this was my best because I grew as an individual, as a person, and as an athlete. I now know how to handle groups, like large groups, with maturity and with respect. But also, I still resort to my old self because no one can change in just 2 short months that season was. But I'm also have gotten really good at getting over it and being able to kick myself in the butt so it doesn't affect the rest of the team. I seized my opportunity as a captain, and this was the time I was at my best. What was it? Is it 5:59?
Yeah.